NASA's Hubble telescope has captured some of the most beautiful photos of space, which have played a major role in helping us explore more of the cosmos. However, every once in a while, the telescope is known to make terrifying discoveries that shake scientists to the core. Whether it be daunting black holes, supernovas, or potential Earth-like planets, there's always something new for astronomers to come across. Since its launch in 1990, the Hubble Space Telescope has provided a dazzling array of images that have awed and inspired the public. But Hubble's about far more than just pretty pictures. The mission has gathered dozens of terabytes of data over the decades, providing key insights into the universe, from objects as close as the moon to the most remote galaxies, with observations of supernovas and nebulas in between. Astronomer Lyman Spitzer was the first to propose launching a space telescope which could overcome the limitations of ground-based observatories in 1946. It took a couple more decades before the idea garnered enough support for the U.S. National Academy of Sciences to organize a committee of scientists to evaluate the potential of a large space telescope. Development on the project began in 1977, with NASA planning to launch the telescope in 1983, but various production delays pushed the launch date back to 1986. In the meantime, the Large Space Telescope was renamed Hubble in honor of Edwin Hubble, an American astronomer who, among other things, determined that the universe extended beyond the borders of the Milky Way. Hubble finally launched aboard the Space Shuttle Discovery on April 24, 1990, and a day later was deployed into low Earth orbit about 340 miles. Getting Hubble developed and launched cost $1.5 billion, but there would be ongoing costs as well, both expected and unexpected. Initial instruments on Hubble included the Wide Field Planetary Camera, the Goddard High Resolution Spectrograph, the Faint Object Camera, the Faint Object Spectrograph, and the High Speed Photometer. More were added over the years in subsequent missions, which allowed astronauts to upgrade and repair the telescope. The Hubble Space Telescope has lasted an astounding 31 years, and in that time, has revolutionized our understanding of the universe. The telescope has been the source of some truly exciting discoveries, even in our cosmic neighborhood. Hubble discovered two new moons of Pluto, dubbed Nix and Hydra, and recently mapped seasonal changes to its surface. Also, by helping to find out the mass of Eris, which is 27% more massive than Pluto, the realization that similar bodies might lurk in the Kuiper Belt and beyond helped demote Pluto and similar objects to dwarf planet status. Future observations of such distant bodies could help scientists better understand how the solar system evolved. Another rare event captured by the telescope was the collision of comet Shoemaker-Levy 9 with Jupiter in 1994. The giant planet's gravitational pull ripped the comet apart into fragments, resulting in 21 visible impacts. The largest collision created a fireball that rose about 1,800 miles above the Jovian cloud tops, as well as a giant dark spot more than 7,460 miles across, about the size of the Earth, and was estimated to have exploded with the force of 6,000 gigatons of TNT. Not only did Hubble's observations heighten public interest in the effects of cosmic impacts, but they also shed light on Jupiter's atmosphere. During June and July 2012, U.S. astronomers using Hubble discovered Styx, a tiny fifth moon orbiting Pluto. In March 2015, researchers announced the measurements of Aurora around Ganymede, one of Jupiter's moons, revealed that it has a subsurface ocean. Using Hubble to study the motion of its Aurora, the researchers determined that a large saltwater ocean was helping to suppress the interaction between Jupiter's magnetic field and that of Ganymede. The ocean is estimated to be 60 miles deep, trapped beneath a 90-mile ice crust. From June to August 2015, Hubble was used in the search for a Kuiper Belt object target for the New Horizons Kuiper Belt extended mission, when similar searches with ground telescopes failed to find a suitable target. This resulted in the discovery of at least five new objects, including the eventual mission target known as 486-958 Arakoth, that New Horizons performed a close flyby of on January 1st, 2019. In August 2020, taking advantage of a total lunar eclipse, astronomers using NASA's Hubble Space Telescope have detected Earth's brand of sunscreen, the ozone, in our atmosphere. This method simulates how astronomers and astrobiology researchers will search for evidence of life beyond Earth by observing potential biosignatures on exoplanets. While the telescope has made some amazing discoveries in the solar system, its true calling has been helping us understand the mysteries of deep space. Dark matter, which is invisible but reveals its existence via gravity, makes up roughly 23% of the universe. By analyzing the distortions caused by dark matter's gravity on light from distant galaxies, Hubble helped construct the largest scale 3D maps scientists have of where dark matter is distributed in the universe. These have helped show the lumpiness of dark matter has increased over time, showing it exhibits ordinary gravity as opposed to something else. Better understanding how dark matter behaves could help scientists figure out what it is. Gamma ray bursts are the most powerful explosions known in the universe, typically cutting loose more energy in seconds than our sun will release in its entire 10 billion year lifetime. The origin of these bursts was a mystery for decades. Hubble helped discover these bursts typically occur in galaxies that were actively forming stars and were low in metallicity. That is, low in elements heavier than helium. This suggested gamma ray bursts emerged as massive stars collapsed to form black holes. Active star-forming galaxies are often rich in massive stars that collapse quickly, and low metallicity stars are more likely to retain their mass and form black holes. Additionally, by determining the rate at which the universe is expanding, Hubble may have helped solve the mystery of how old the universe is, but it is unexpectedly turned up an even more profound one. The fact that the rate of the universe's expansion is not slowing down or even constant, but is inexplicably accelerating. The culprit behind this, dubbed dark energy, is now thought to make up 74% of the combined mass energy in the entire universe, and it remains an utter enigma. Solving this mystery could revolutionize physics as we know it. Before Hubble, it was highly uncertain as to when the universe was born, which could lead to unbearable paradoxes, such as the laughable possibility that stars astronomers detected were older than our universe. By greatly narrowing down the rate at which the universe is expanding, Hubble helped refine estimates of the universe's age down to roughly 13.75 billion years, a result that not only plays a role in modeling how our universe has evolved, but also in our understanding of other seemingly unrelated cosmic parameters, such as the mass of neutrinos. One of the latest discoveries made by the telescope may be the most terrifying yet. The new snapshot shows a dying star, specifically a red giant star. Known as CW Leonis, the star is a truly incredible sight. It has a bright flash of light at its center and eerie rings surrounding it. The spiral shape also resembles several things, including a portal to another dimension, a cosmic witch cauldron, or even a spider web from a nightmarish space spider. Located 400 light-years from Earth, CW Leonis is the closest carbon star to our planet. The relatively short distance makes it easy for astronomers to study the intricate details of CW Leonis, especially compared to other stars much further away. One such detail is the dusty clouds around the outside of CW Leonis. These are large amounts of carbon being ejected out from the star. CW Leonis's nuclear fusion creates carbon. The carbon grows in the star's interior, and it's eventually shot out into space, creating the cloudy look seen in the picture. There are also the light beams emitting from CW Leonis. NASA says that their brightness has changed a lot over the last 15 years, which is an incredibly short period in astronomical terms. The reason for this change in brightness isn't 100% known, but astronomers have an idea. Astronomers speculate that gaps in the dust shrouding CW Leonis may allow beams of starlight to pierce through and illuminate dust like searchlight beacons through a cloudy sky. And of course, there's CW Leonis's striking color. The reason for its orange-red hue is the low 2,300 degree Fahrenheit surface temperature. That might sound incredibly hot compared to the temperature on Earth, but it's a far cry from the sun's 27 million degree Fahrenheit temperatures. CW Leonis also has some beams that shine at invisible wavelengths, so ones that appear in green have been edited by NASA for better analysis. Adding all of these things together makes CW Leonis one of the most terrifying cosmic objects observed so far. We hope you found today's video informative. Please remember to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon to continue this amazing journey with us. What do you think is Hubble's greatest discovery? Please share your thoughts in the comments section below.